Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the Rebeltech channel. Thank you for joining me. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the last ever MacBook White, the A1342 MacBook 13 inch mid 2010. I'm going to be telling you why this MacBook White is still relevant in 2022 onwards and it's collectible. This is the last MacBook White that Apple released before they discontinued in perhaps I think 2011. And I'm going to be booting up and show you that this machine right here, this obsolete, this vintage, maybe to most it's useless model, this MacBook White is running MacOS Monterey. Right now it's quite cheap if you were to get it anywhere in your marketplace. I got this in pristine condition on eBay. I've yet to upgrade the RAM to 16GB. It's quite pricey, just take note that the 16GB, you have to find 8GB 8500x2. Yeah, this is running on macOS and this is also able to boot Windows 11. This is Windows 11 Pro 21H2 and it's running Windows 11 fine. So it's still relevant today. I'm also able to run this with macOS Monterey, Windows 10, Android, or macOS Monterey and Windows 11. It depends on your personal preference. People will be definitely saying to me, why not Linux? No offense, I love Linux, but 90% don't use Linux, except for us that's comfortable with Linux. Let's start off with macOS Monterey and Windows 11. So how do I install macOS Monterey and Windows 11? This model right here has two SSDs, of which one is macOS Monterey and the other one is Windows 11. In any case, macOS failed, Windows 11 will still run perfectly fine. If Windows 11 failed, macOS will still run fine. How do I install? It's very simple. First thing first, if you can, this is just one of the tricks. There's a few ways. If you were to follow all my videos from the past and moving forward, I will share different kind of method of how you can install, and I'm the only one that does that. This is the first. You will need to have the MacBook Pro. What I use is a MacBook Pro 15 inch 2011 and I install macOS Monterey. You know, you need to create the boot disk and all that stuff. You can watch on my other videos. You would have to need to watch in order for you to understand, because if you don't understand and you decide straight away to jump on this, you won't learn anything. So you won't learn from your mistakes and all that stuff. Hey everyone, this video was actually filmed back in 2022 when Monterey first came out. Now, you might be asking, why put a brand new operating system on this relic of a laptop? Well, here's the thing. Thanks to the incredible work of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher team running Monterey and even Ventura, or Sonoma as they call it, on older Macs is easier than ever. This patcher basically unlocks hidden potential in these machines, giving them a new lease on life. Just follow these simple steps. Of course, the 2.4 GHz Core 2 Duo aren't exactly powerhouses, but for basic tasks like browsing, document editing, and even light video editing, it's surprisingly usable. Sure, you won't be editing 4K footage or playing the latest AAA games, but for casual use, it is just fine. And hey, that vintage keyboard feel undeniably satisfying. Another thing to consider, you'll lose some features found on Macs with newer processors, like AirDrop and Sidecar. So it's running Monterey, Windows 10, or 11, or even Android on a 2010 MacBook White, worth it? That depends. If you're looking for modern powerhouse, definitely not. But if you're a tech enthusiast, love tinkering, and want to breathe new life into an old machine, then absolutely. It is a fun project and a learning experience. You could take out the drive and SSD. We would need a a new drive or fresh drive, don't install anything that has data on it. You install Windows 11 on a desktop or a laptop. You can install it in UEFI mode. What I did was legacy mode. Once you install Windows 11, we would need also the ISO, preferably the non-TPM ISO. So, and then you install on a laptop, a Windows laptop. Take out the drive, put it here, and then install bootcamp drivers. That's about it. If you were to follow my technique on the MacBook Pro 15-inch 2012, we can install via bootcamp. It will work perfectly fine. There's a lot of techniques, there's a lot of methods to do, so I'll be sharing different methods. I will share in the description box down below. There's more. If let's say you don't like Windows 11, let's say you prefer Windows 10, same thing. We install Windows 10 on a Windows desktop or Windows laptop in UEFI mode or on legacy, which I prefer legacy, and then slap that bitch inside this model as a secondary drive. So you have two drives. You replace the DVD with an SSD. How to install three operating system? Simple. You hear it here first. So you can install macOS Monterey on a single drive. Windows 10, same method. Install on a desktop or laptop, legacy mode. You cannot use UEFI mode. This is for those who don't really care about UEFI mode or whatever, and you just want to stick to Windows 10. That's about it. You would have to install Windows version 19.09, and you would need to stop the updates. You can only update the drivers, but you would need to stop the Windows from updating to a newer version. So you would have to be stuck on Windows 19.09. Only then you would be able to install Prime OS, Android OS on the Windows drive partition. And yeah, you would have to watch my other videos to learn, especially the Mac Mini video that I've released. I'm gonna recap everything to install macOS Monterey. You can find a MacBook Pro 13-inch 2011 or 2012 to install macOS Monterey, and then take out the drive, put it here, or on MacBook Pro 15-inch 2011 or 2012. If you want to run bootcamp, I would advise you to use the MacBook Pro 15-inch 2012, install macOS Monterey and bootcamp Windows 11. It's very simple. If you want to run three operating systems, Windows, Android, macOS in one machine. This video is not for everyone. I'm interested in the 30% that's willing to learn to further the limit of the MacBook. You could do this on the MacBook White 2009 A1342 and MacBook White mid-2010 A1342. I understand Windows 11 has Android support and whatsoever. If you want to run separate operating system, Windows 10 version 19.09. That's the only version that you can install Android, but you would have to install Windows 10 on a Windows desktop or laptop. Windows 10 legacy mode. You cannot install Windows 10 on UEFI mode. Once you install that, put it here, and then proceed to install Prime OS partition. Go on, start a tech business. I'll probably get a lot of like criticism or flack, which I don't care. So I'm sharing this knowledge, this experience to those who are interested to learn, alright? And those who are interested to tinker, old Mac, stay tuned. I'm gonna be releasing quite a lot of videos coming up. Bye bye.